Back everyone, this is Moni Singh and we are going to start new chapter, that is transportation of materials. Okay, so what is transportation? Transportation is basically to transport something from one place to another place, to carry something from one part of the body to another part of the body. Okay, so why transportation is necessary? As we discussed in prior chapters that after nutrition the nutrients are carried to different cells of the body. Why? Because body needs energy, and from where we can get energy? From food particles only, from the nutrients of food only we can get energy. So here is transport, we need to transport the nutrients, the molecules of food from one part of the body, that is from small intestine, to another part, that is different cells. Okay, in last chapter we discussed about respiration, how oxygen is carried from through actually lungs, from lungs to different parts of the body. Okay, so that oxygen also needs to be transported from lungs to different parts of the body, from alveoli of the lungs to different parts of the body. So again, why we need to transport oxygen? To carry oxygen, because oxygen oxidizes the food particles, correct? Okay, so how the nutrients are carried, how oxygen is carried to different parts of the body? Through blood only. So blood is the part of our circulatory system that carries all the kind of useful as well as waste materials from one part of the body to another part of the body. Okay, so why transportation is necessary? For getting energy, for getting nutrients basically, and through nutrients it is having the chemical energy stored. So for getting energy, how we can get energy? Through oxidation of food. And finally, that energy enable us to do different works. So transportation is necessary for all these kind of purposes. Okay, now again, what is transportation? It is a life process in which various substances carried from one part of the body to another part of the body. Okay, now let us discuss about some simple organisms, some microscopic and unicellular as well as simple multicellular organism, how the process of transportation takes place in such kind of organisms. Amoeba, paramecium, bacteria, hydra, spirogyra, in all these kind of organisms transportation takes place through diffusion only, through the process of diffusion from its body surface only transportation takes place, correct? Now in advanced organisms, the organisms which are quite advanced, those organisms are having a system that is called circulatory system. That system only do the process of circulation, that system only do the process of transport of materials from one part of the body to another part of the body. That depends where is the materials are found in abundance and where there is lacking. So basically transportation happens from abundance to lacking, from the part where it is in abundance and from the part where it there is lacking of such kind of materials. Okay, now let us discuss about circulatory system in human, how the mode of transportation circulation takes place in human. So in human basically transportation takes place through blood. Blood is a fluid part, fluid found in our body that runs in a tube like structure called blood vessels. So blood runs in blood vessels, and blood is fluid that carries each and every materials from one part of our body to another part of the body, no matter those materials are useful or waste material. So it carries useful material to different cells and waste materials from cell to outside of the body for removal. Okay, so what is the function, what are the different functions of blood? ब्लड बेसिकली कैरीज डाइजेस्टेड फूड फ्रॉम स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन टू अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी फ्रॉम स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन टू ईच एंड एवरी सेल ऑफ द बॉडी फॉर ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स ओके बेसिकली इट टेक्स न्यूट्रिएंट्स and supply to each and every cell because all cells need nutrients for oxidation. Now blood carries oxygen from lungs to the cells of the body. It carries oxygen from lungs, from alveoli of lungs and take it to the each and every cell of the body. Why? For oxidation of nutrients, correct? For cellular respiration. So this is now next one at the same time blood also carries carbon dioxide from body cells to lungs for removing the carbon dioxide outside of the body understood now next one it carries waste product from cells to kidney blood also carries waste product from each cells of the body to kidney for removal it from body to outside in the form of urine in the form of sweat okay correct in next episode we'll discuss in detail about the human circulatory system the different organs of human circulatory system parts of human circulatory system now you look at the screen